as the song ends.
Thank you.
Does it not just segue into, hey, time to open up tonight, time to get up here and tell you, welcome to the Duncan Showroom. Here we are for another evening, another sunny day in downtown Duncan. Yeah, where's all this rain coming from? I think it's now been 10 days of no rain in two and a half months. Ouch. And when we didn't have any rain, we just had freezing weather. Oh, well, now we've got all that out of the way. It'll be fun. But, you know, I've always learned that never plant before May 24th weekend anything anyway, because it's just, you can never trust the way things are out there. And right now, I don't think I trust much of anything other than where my next breath might be coming from. I don't know if you've been watching the news lately, but boy, that number 45 sure got the world going in a, he knows how to use the media, doesn't he, eh? Well, we're using the media tonight because we're broadcasting live. We've got our own Duncan Showroom YouTube channel, which means that this is broadcast out to the real world for those who want to watch it tonight or at a later time, which is great for those people who get to stay home and not pay. See, now my thought is, if you're at home, you're probably sitting in the clothes of your choice, in the chair of your choice, on a really nice TV, imbibing on the beverage of your choice, and the fresh air of your choice. And that should be worth $5 more than the going ticket price here is. Just for that luxury of us bringing it to your living room or bedroom or wherever you are watching it from. One of the things I like to do is in days to come by from now, what I do during the day when I'm on the computer doing, getting everything ready for the 39 days of July, is I start, I just put a previous show in the background and just listen to it as my radio station. And it's really cool, the music that gets to be produced that way in this valley. And a big thanks to Ted Cadillac, our sound tech, for making sure that all happens. What an interesting guy. You'll find out tonight just how good he is. Big round of applause for him, please. And if he gets to watch the TV thing, you'll understand, because he's working on 5 different cameras while he's also doing the sound. And he never leaves it. He's always on the money. Tonight, one of the things we get to do is celebrate the slide guitar by two people who seem to travel as far and wide to get themselves around it and involved in it whichever way they can. And they kind of, I would have to say, probably live and breathe it and use it for pillows or take it to bed. They probably got double beds with guitars beside them. I'm not sure. Whew, few assortments tonight. But anyway, to start off tonight, we're going to have Sue Decker get up first, and then we're going to have Bob Blair get up for another short period after that. Then we'll take a break. And then they'll get up and we'll do what we were calling in the round, but in a straight line. Right? Sue came to us a couple years ago. It's not something you hear much with women who get involved with slide guitar to the extent that she has. So when she came, it was really great. I think we had a marathon night that first night, something like an hour and a half, 2 hour concert. Something like that. It was just great. A whole bunch of tunes. It was really fun. But she's here tonight. And I think she's been back since that again. She's got a CD that she did around town here that Zach worked on. So she's no stranger to this community, but I'm sure glad that she's back again tonight to visit us. Sue Decker, just give her a warm welcome, please.
Hello, everybody. thanks for coming. And thanks to John for that introduction. Yeah, slide guitar is a pretty big deal in my world. I do not sleep with it. Sometimes I dream about it, but... Right. So I'm going to start off the night with a tune by a boogie-woogie piano player called Eden Brent. She's from New Orleans. And I love love the piano. I wish I could play, but I can't. And so I'm going to do my best on the dobro, this one. This one's called Blues All Over Me. Blues on that love seat where we used to kiss. Alone in my living room, my man is sorely missed. I got the blues all over. Blues, they won't let me be. I got the blues all over. Blues all over me, yeah. I got blues at the table at his empty seat. Feeling mighty hungry, but these blues won't let me eat. I got the blues all over. Blues, they won't let me be. Oh no, I got the blues all over. Blues all over me, yeah. I got blues when I'm happy, and I got blues when I'm sad. Blues, my only comfort when he makes me mad. Blues, where I'm going. Blues everywhere behind, can't get rid of all my blues. Now I've quit from trying. Blues in the cupboard, on the shelf by the gym, drinking by myself because he did not come home again. I got the blues all over. Blues, they won't let me be. Oh no, I got the blues all over. Blues all over. Folks here are from Duncan. Well, good to meet ya. I know a few people from Duncan. And the rest, I imagine, are from parts unknown, other parts. All right. Well, so this song is a song that I wrote that's called Too Close to the Bone, and it's a song that that started when I was down at blues camp, blues workshop down in Port Townsend, Washington, and was listening to a concert, and I've had that experience a few times where I'm talking to or listening to some music and a song just kind of starts sprouting in my head, and I gotta go and write it down, because contrary to what somebody told me, that if the song is good, you'll remember it. Not me. I gotta write it down. So this one's called Too Close to the Bone. Thank you. All right. Well, it's a real pleasure to be back here at the Duncan Showroom with my friend Bob Blair. I guess this is our third year running, end of April, little shindig at Duncan Showroom. For those of you who don't know, I lived in Edmonton for many, many years, so that's where I met Bob, and he's still there, and I got to move out here. So it's a pleasure to be here. So I started a project last year, a songwriting project, that was based on inspiration from the paintings of Emily Carr. So I kind of was looking through books and going to art galleries and checking out her painting, but also doing quite a bit of reading about her and also reading of what she'd written, what she's written. And what has surprised me so far is that I've actually gotten more songwriting inspiration from her writing. So if you've not checked out any of her writing, it's really quite something. And her life was also just quite inspiring. You know, her dedication to art was pretty amazing. So this song is relatively new off the, hence the words, new off the press, I guess. I also went for an optometry appointment yesterday for the first time in about 7, 8, 10 years. And so, yeah, we'll see if the geezer font is big enough for me to put it down there. But anyway, no. So anyway, this one was inspired by a story that she'd written, and a lot of her writing is very autobiographical, but it's hard to tell, you know, I mean, who knows, I guess, with any autobiography, how much of it is true, but yeah, she wrote a few stories that read more like short stories, and in one of the stories that she wrote, she was summoned to a woman's deathbed. And the woman who's dying did not have any children, and so the community was around her, but she did not have any children there. And of course, Emily Carr did not have any children either. And so it was just something that I related to, and so that's where this song comes from. You needed to know the long version, right? It's called Woman Who Has No Child. What does a farmer who has no land do every morning with his idle hands? Oh, he's got seeds in his pocket and he got nowhere to plant. He is a farmer. Brother, the wind, how he understands. Rain, his companion, the sun, his right-hand man. All the wisdom of the ages was still at his command. Listen to the farmer who has no preacher who has no faith do at the pulpit while his congregation waits. Does he bear false witness or does he dare to say, I am a preacher who has no faith? Imagine the silence in the church that day. Who will cast the first stone at the one who's gone astray? Well, who is gonna stand up and minister and pray for the lonely preacher who has no faith? Child, do on her deathbed, can you hear her cry? Well, have I been forsaken by the tree of life? I am a woman who has no child. till she meets her family on the other side. Does she hear the keening in the morning leave behind? Or does she hear the crying in the morning for this precious woman who has no Thank you. So tonight you are going to see a selection of lap slide instruments. This one here is a resophonic guitar, dobro, which Bob also has. And this guitar is a regular acoustic guitar. It's about 1958 Harmony. And I know that this guitar was played by a lot of the sort of old blues guys. It's kind of sought after, even though most of them, when you find them nowadays, the neck is so far out of whack that you can't actually play it in the regular way. And so a grand fellow at a music store in Edmonton, Myers Music, I probably told this story about this guitar, but so this fellow at Myers Music in Edmonton, when I came in the store one day, said, "I got something you might like." And we went into the back, and that's what was there. So I converted it, put a big nut, my cousin, the luthier, Dylan Rovere, down in Victoria, put a big nut on it so I can play it like this, which is my preference. This is a song called Traveling Light, and it's one that I wrote just as I was getting ready to move away from Edmonton and was downsizing. So it's called Traveling Light. I'm pulling out all those tangled roots. I'm washing all the gumbo off my boots. Go now. I ain't got no load to weigh me down. I'm pulling out. No, I just sang that. I'm dumping out the ashes of old flames. I'm gonna let the wind blow them away. Breaking free from that big boss man. I wanna let the wind blow them away. I'm traveling light, watch me go now. I ain't got no load to weigh me down. Thank you. I'm gonna let my secrets fly out the door. I don't need those burdens no more. I'm traveling light, watch me go now. I ain't got no load to weigh me down. Share the road day by day. I'm traveling light, watch me go now. I ain't got no load to weigh me down. I ain't got no load to weigh me down. I ain't got no load to weigh me down. Thank you. I have no idea when we started, but I'll play a few more. And then Bob's going to come up and do a short set as well. And then we are going to share the stage. So this next song is it's an oldie. It's a Bessie Smith tune from, I think, 28, but I'm not sure. I always guess 1928 when I'm talking about these old tunes, because it sounds good. And it's in the ballpark, I assure you. This is a song called Jailhouse Blues, and not something I have any experience with, but it's a really cool song, so I'm doing it. Back turned to the wall. 30 days in jail with my back turned to the wall. Well, look here, Mr. Jailkeeper. Oh, somebody gone in my stall. Oh, I don't mind being in jail. I got to stay there so long. I don't mind being in jail, but I got to stay there so long. Well, my good friend, they done shook hands and gone. Oh, you better stop your man tickling me under my chin. You better stop your man from tickling me under my chin. Yeah, he don't stop tickling. I'm gonna take him on in. Have a few words with you. Yeah, just come down here to have a few words with you. Thanks, folks. And thanks again for coming out. All right. So, let's see. I got one more tune. Uh-oh, wardrobe issue. Oops. All right, so we're going to take a very short break, I think, in between myself and Bob's set, and then I will be back after the break. Hope you guys all stick around. I hope you're enjoying yourselves so far. Mm-hmm, good. All right, so this last song I'm going to do is a song, another song that I wrote, and this also was one that started when I was at Blues Workshop in Port Townsend, Washington. This one's a bit of a cheeky one. It's called Please, Please, Baby. Everybody, we'll have a short break, and Bob Blair will be up shortly. Thank you.
No escape. escape, no escape, no escape, no. That night, I grabbed hold of my urge, pierced to my surprise. It's alright, deep within myself, engaged in sensuality, with no escape, no escape, no escape, no escape, no escape, no escape. Leave me here, lost in your eyes, lusting, lusting, lusting. Leave me here.
Short intermission. The full one with the beverages and everything else and the popcorn will be ready right after Bob Blair plays. Bob Blair plays. Wash my tongue. By the way, I don't know if you noticed on the way in, there has been a guy that's been up and down this street trying to panhandle money for the last 24 hours. Guy says he's addicted to brake fluid. I said, brake fluid? He says, yeah, it's okay. I can stop whenever I want. Yeah, well, you know, we have comedy here. You should come down and check it out sometimes. We have professional comedy. That's what it is, yeah. Now, this is a great thing. We have a connection that I had the opportunity when I was in 1970 looking for my good friend Gerald Craigie and his newfound, they were about to have a baby, him and his wife, and they lived in Lethbridge. And I showed up. I remember coming around that first hill and then look and seeing that bridge and just went, I'm in love with this place. So I ended up hanging out with Lethbridge for a long, long time. There's a lot of great musicians came out of Lethbridge. Nothing of great, nothing that you see in the limelight, but trust me, the quality of musicianship that's come out of Lethbridge is phenomenal. I think it has a lot to do with the wind and just the general atmosphere that goes on there. But Bob Blair is one of those people who grew up in that area. And, you know, slide guitar is just a pedal steel slide. Anything to do with that kind of country feel, it's something that you're pretty prone to be heading towards musically. And so he's spent a lot of time because he's found out not only through blues and just all the different genres that slide can be used in. Again, he's one of those guys who's in love with it. And she said she didn't, but I'm not sure this guy doesn't sleep with his guitars. when he travels. And he does carry a lot of guitars usually with him when he travels. He didn't bring them all this time. I don't know what happened. Oh, right, the airlines are charging way too much now, eh? Yeah. Anyway, we'll be getting him up right now. He'll do his set, and then we'll take a break where you can get up and walk around, check out the wonderful things in the Duncan Showroom. I'll be here to give you a little guided tour if you want. But in the meantime, let's give a warm welcome, please, to Mr. Bob Blair.
Thank you, John. Yeah, we used to call him John the Leather Worker when he turned up in my hometown, and he stayed for something like 7 years. There we go. Okay. I'm going to jump right into something. I've been thinking about, you know, going home and stuff, and John talking about Lethbridge, which is my old hometown. Mostly where I grew up. you know, I read that Thomas Wolfe novel, You Can't Go Home Again, and I can't remember a thing about it. But I've spent a fair bit of time in Lethbridge recently, and it's kind of an experiment to see if I could carry on the life while living in southern Alberta in this old family home. And I saw Robert Persick, who wrote Zen and the Art of Motorcycle Maintenance, just passed away. And it was that book that taught me that an experiment that produces information isn't a failure. But and you can, in fact, go home again. I'm not sure that you need to or you always should. Didn't. But there was an alley in Lethbridge, and I was driving down it to try and park somewhere. And this happened several times over the last year where I had this sense of, you know, deja vu, I've been here before. What is it about this alley? Well, it was, there was an old house there, and my friend Randy from across the street when I was a kid had pointed out this house, and his mother had told him about this house. And you'd see it kind of fronted on the alley, and it's gone now. And he said, well, the Protestants lived there. And Protestants, whatever, you know, he was an LDS kid, a lot of big LDS community there. And he said, yeah, well, they, you know, they pull the shades down, and people pay money to go in there, and they do the thing that makes babies for money. And so what I was remembering really was I was having this memory whenever I went down that alley of the conversation with Randy, and I don't know whatever became of him, like a lot of people from my old hometown. And this song's kind of about that and kind of about leaving. It's a Bob McDill tune. I'll save my own tunes for when I'm playing with Sue later, but what do you do with good old boys like me? When I was a kid, Uncle Remus would put me to bed with a picture of Stonewall Jackson above my head. Then Daddy came in to kiss his little man, gin on his breath and a bottle in his hand. He talked about honor and things I should know, and he staggered a little as he went out the door. I can still hear the soft southern wind in the live oak tree. Those Williams boys, they still mean a lot to me. Hank in Tennessee, I guess we're all gonna be what we're gonna be. What do you do with good old? Nothing makes a sound in the night like the windows, but you ain't afraid if you're washed in the blood like I was. The scent of jasmine through the window screen, John R. and the Wolfman kept me company by the light of a radio by my bed. with Thomas Wolfe whispering in my head. You can still hear the soft southern wind in the live oak tree. Those Williams boys still mean a lot to me. Hank and Tennessee, I guess we're all gonna be what we're gonna be. What do you do with good old boys like me? When I was in school, I ran with a kid down the street. And I watched him burn himself up on bourbon and speed. But I was smarter than most and I could choose. I learned to talk like the man on the 6 o'clock news. When I was 18, Lord, I hit the road. But it really doesn't matter how far I go. I can still hear the soft southern wind in the live oak tree. Those Williams boys still mean a lot to me. Hank and Tennessee, guess we're all gonna be what we're gonna be. What do you do with good old boys like me? Thank you. Okay, Joan was talking about things with slides, so I'll get down to that. This guitar over here is a Weisenborn-style guitar made by a gentleman named Carol Benoit, a Cajun who lives in Texas, and he calls it his Cajun-born. He also made that resonator guitar, and he's through the Texas Steel Guitar Show, he became a very good friend of mine, and I've got three instruments that he built, and two of them are here with me tonight. You all hear that? Yeah, Willie Nelson just turned, 84. He wrote a song that he said was for his daughter, or about his daughter, and when I thought of it that way, it really hit me. And I mean, I know exactly what he means and what he's feeling, I think. So this is something about my life as a parent. It's not supposed to be this way. You're supposed to know I love you, but it don't matter anyhow. If I can't be there to console, it's not supposed to be this way. You're supposed to know I love you, but it don't matter anyhow. If I can't be there to control you, just like the other little children, you gotta dream a dream or two. But be careful what you're dreaming. Soon your dreams will be dreaming you. It's not supposed to be this way. You're supposed to know I love you, but it don't matter anyhow. If I can't be there to supposed to be this way. You're supposed to know I love you, but it don't matter anyhow. If I can't be there, you can store me. When you go out to play this evening, play with fireflies till they're gone, then run to meet your lover. Play with real fire till the dawn. Not supposed to be this in the United States. It's a difficult time, and it's a very sad time for many of them, and especially through the music and the steel guitar community. I've got a lot of really close friends down there, and some of them with different views of what's going on, but I think it's a tortured country right now. And you know, when I was young, I remember, you know, that there was this anti-Americanism that pervaded, you know, sort of, you know, left-wing Canadian politics, and I think misses the point that these are our neighbors, these are people we love, we share so much culturally with these people. You can't just walk away, and you can't build a wall either, Donald. But so I did, I strung together some of my favorite American music into an instrumental, and you'll recognize some of these tunes, I hope. Thank you. Well, it's time for a song about a woman. Great line from that Jack Nicholson movie, Five Easy Pieces, where his friend Elton says to him, don't you know, or he says to his friend Elton, don't you know any songs about women or nothing? I got a new electric guitar the other month and was having fun with it, and I started playing it, and it wanted to play this song. That's what it wanted to do, and it reminded me of this old Johnny Cash song. Lord, she's restless, like cotton candy clouds that sail the day. Mind that can't resign itself to stay for long with me. Though I've tried and tried to keep her tied and satisfied till she really needs me. Yes, I do. When that certain look comes on her face, I can't replace it and she leaves me. She's a butterfly in mid-July who just can't wait to try her brand new wings on brand new things. And she needs no rhyme or reason when she goes. Her wine might as well lies beyond that wall of blue horizon, I suppose. And heaven knows she'll go sailing off on any old wind. Yes, she will, yes, she will. She'll go sailing off on any old wind that blows. Well, she needs me about as much as I need someone else, which I don't. And if need be, I swear someday I'll up and leave myself, which I won't. Mind if I played you another instrumental on the dobro this time? Yeah, one of my big thrills in terms of my musical career, such as it is, it's hard to call something a career that you lose that much money on, but that's still kind of the way I see it. I was invited to play the main stage at the Texas Steel Guitar Show on the annual Jamboree in Dallas, and I've been part of that show for quite a few years and played some other venues within it, but and the main stage for steel guitar player, the main stage in Dallas is kind of the daddy of them all. And I think it was some version of this medley of, sort of Celtic-flavored tunes that I was doing that caught the ear of the president of the TSGA, Texas Steel Guitar Association. And so he invited me to play the main stage this year, which was, a pretty big deal for me. And I got a time slot at 4 p.m. on a Friday afternoon. So you got this ballroom, it's full of people, and some of my musical heroes were in the room. And I prevailed on some of my favorite L.A. musicians who were there to get up and be part of the staff band for me. It was really something. And I think this medley, I think that Albert, the president, decided I was God's gift to the Dobro, which is overstating it, but I'm glad he liked it.
Thank you.
Okay, my friend Jana in Texas might be listening. She's a singer and a dobro player. Lives near Dallas. I can't remember the name of her town. And I'm sorry, Jana, I didn't put red at the is a rose in front of that. Sometimes I do, and sometimes it just doesn't seem to work. But I'll send this one out to Jana. She said she was going to try and listen on the live stream. And, it wasn't on my list, but I can't read my list anyway without my glasses. So. And there is no font big enough. That's just the way it is. But this is a song I've been doing on with using Wise and Born for a long time, and a song I've been doing for pretty much forever. I learned it from my grade 10 roommate, Charlie Ewing, who's a very fine Western singer-songwriter I sometimes do some shows with. I'm doing one with him next month, actually. But he taught me this song when we were in high school. He learned it from an Ian Tyson, Ian and Sylvia record. Where the Walker runs down to the Carson Valley Plain, there lived a maiden, Darcy Fair was her name, the daughter of old Dundee, and a fair one was she, and the sweetest flower that bloomed over the rain. Her voice was sweet as a sugar candy, her touch was as soft as a bed of goose down, her eyes shone bright like the pretty lights that shine in the night out of Yarrington town. Well, she was courted by a young man and quite handsome was he as I am. He brought us silver rings and lace of bands, and they promised to wed before the snow began to fall. Here comes the sad part. But her pony stumbled and she did fall. Her dying touched the hearts of us one and all. Darcy Farrell, where the truckie runs through. They sing of her beauty in Virginia City, too. At dusky sundown, to her name they drink around. And to young Vandy, whose love was true. Where the Walker runs down. Darcy Farrell was her name, the daughter of old Dundee, and a fair one was she, and the sweetest flower that bloomed o'er the rain. Thank you. Darcy Farrell. Maybe if I got time for one more, and then we'll take our intermission. I'll do you one on the regular guitar, which I've been playing a lot longer than anything else. Mostly, people hire me to play pedal steel guitar for them, and I love doing that. But you know, I always wanted to sing, and my grade five teacher told me I couldn't. And, yeah, and I still remember her name, you know. And why I don't remember the name of the grade eight English teacher who played me Steel Rail Blues by Gordon Lightfoot and blew my mind, I don't know. But I remember I remember the name of that teacher that told me I couldn't sing. And when I was on the main stage in Dallas, I mentioned that, and I said, "Well, Mrs. Earl," I said, I'm singing in Texas. How do you like me now?" I have to sing this song a particular way. There was a friend of mine in my hometown who was a preacher, and the only preacher I could ever really tolerate. His name was Bill, and we did a lot of stuff together, and we were good friends, and a lot of the people in his congregation didn't, you know, think well of me or of his friendship with me. But he was a pretty cool guy. He actually sort of spirited a nun away from a convent in Medicine Hat and married her, and I thought that was a pretty cool thing to do. And he used to go down to the States on these preacherly tours, and, you know, he'd go to Oklahoma, and from Lethbridge, Alberta to Lawton, Oklahoma, figure that one out. You know. And he came back and he told story of this, told stories about snake handling preachers and things. I got a song about that I'm going to do later. But a few years ago, he passed away. He had some serious health issues. And I was a long way away. I wasn't able to go to his funeral, and it wasn't sure I'd be welcome anyway, which was really silly of me. But I couldn't make it. And then about a year after his funeral, I got a telephone message from his wife, the former sister Barbara, saying that she'd found a letter. And it was from, she needed my address because she needed to mail me this letter that Bill had written to me before he died. I thought, wow. So I left the phone and left her a message with my address. And, you know, for a few days I anticipated this letter and wondering what it could possibly be. And it turned out just he didn't have a lot of time. And he just was a sort of a nice celebration of our friendship and remembering some of the crazy stuff we got into, fixing the brakes on cars and things like that. And driving down from Cameron Lake in Waterton with wreck brakes. After Bill's fix-it job, you know, stuff like that. But he had a request, and the request was he wanted me to sing at his funeral. So I'd already missed the gig. I knew that, you know. And he wanted me to sing this song by Tom Russell. And there's a line in the song about, it's a funeral that happens in the song, and there's a line that says, there's a preacher and an old pine box. And he wanted me to sing, saying, a preacher in an old pine box. And of course, you know. So this is for my friend. So every time I do this song now, and it's an important song to me, and, great song, I have to do it Bill's way for Bill, and I have to tell that story. It's called Blue Wing. He had a blue wing tattooed on his shoulder. Well, it might have been a bluebird, I don't know. But he'd get stone drunk and talk about Alaska. Salmon boats and 45 below. He said he got that blue wing up in Walla Walla. And his cellmate there was little Willie John. Once a great blues singer, and Wing and Willie wrote up a song. They said, it's dark in here, can't see the sky, but I look at this blue wing and I close my eyes. Then I fly away beyond these worlds, up above the clouds, where the rain don't. And he moved north picking apples to the town of one-eyed sheep, till winter finally caught him in a rundown trailer park on the south side of Seattle, where the days grow gray and dark. Then he drank and he dreamt a vision of when the salmon still ran free, when his father's fathers crossed that wild old barren sea, when the land belonged to everyone. There were old songs yet to sing. Now it's narrowed down to a cheap hotel. Sky, but I look at this blue wing and I close my eyes. Then I fly away beyond these walls, up above the clouds, where the rain don't fall on a poor man's dream. To LA, that's where he died. No one knew his Christian name, and there was no one there to cry. But I dreamt there was a funeral, a preacher in an old pine box, and halfway through the sermon, Blue Wing began to talk. He said, "It's dark in here, can't see the sky, but I look at this blue wing and I close my eyes. Then I fly away beyond these walls, up above the cloud, where the rain don't fall on a poor man's dream." Hey, on a poor man's dream. Hey, on a poor man's dream. Thank you. I'm looking forward to being back up here after intermission with my friend Sue Decker, and I'm always just thrilled to be playing with Sue, and she just sounds better and better every year. So stick around, please. Thanks.
I think it's not healthy. Even if I think it's so
well, this is as we're getting ready for the second part of the show, the in the round in a straight line. I'd just like to point out a few things here. First of all, I've been showing everybody, where everyone became aware, I'm sure, that there's a lot of secondhand used items in the showroom. And matter of fact, the showroom actually started a little over 14 years ago by me procuring 150 soft seat theater seats for free by answering an ad in the paper. And they came from the Jehovah's Witnesses in Souk, which was funny because the last day they needed them was December 25th, which was a Saturday. So I had to pick them up on the 26th. So I've been telling everyone I received a Christmas present from the Jehovah's Witnesses so I could open up a music venue. Well, you know, but one of the things, well, the reason I'm bringing that up is because these things sometimes have a history that comes with it, and every so often that history crops up. And so one of the things I warn anyone who's been sitting in those chairs tonight, do be careful. If you do become anal and retentive and you want to start knocking on door and handing out literature, resist. Okay? And another reason I bring that up is because an interesting story just happened to me a while back. Is that are you all familiar with Value Village and their Seniors Day on Tuesday? You know, if you're over 60, you get a third off, which is great because I take all my friends up there and just buy for them because I like buying, right? But I actually got carded. You know how good that feels to get carded at a Value Village? Yeah. Yeah. 160. What's it to you? But anyway, I was in there, and being tall, it's really, you usually have a lot of understanding. In other words, you have long feet. It's very hard to find shoes to fit you, and they're really expensive when they're big, so I usually look for secondhand ones. And sure enough, I've been able to find a lot of shoes over the years, but my favorite was the red high tops that I found. That I was just like really intrigued by them. I was like, wow, I've always wanted these, and they were in good condition. And it was a Tuesday, so I got a third off, so like $12. For red high tops? Wow. So I was wearing for about 2 weeks or so, and then it became very apparent what there was a history with this, that the guy that had owned them before me had been a drug dealer. Because I don't know what he had laced them with, but I kept on tripping. Comedy, professional comedy here. Every so often, ladies and gentlemen, make sure you check our calendar. But right now...
He's here all week.
Every week after week after week. Anyway, you heard them singularly. Now you're going to get a chance to hear them do it together. It's really quite nice to hear the guitars working together and the styles that they bring together. Give them a warm welcome, please. Sue and Bob.
Thanks, John. And thanks, everybody, for hanging out with us. It's pretty cool to come and play the Duncan Showroom for many reasons, two of which are the big hug I got from John and from sound guy Tim, Ted, call him whatever you want. When you go to play shows, I've been to not that many, but enough where I'm going to a place I've never been before, meeting all these people I don't know, and it's just... Yeah, it's really cool to come to Duncan Showroom and see some old friends. So we're going to start with a song that I wrote called Silver Anniversary. And everybody familiar with what the Silver Anniversary is? Okay, well, how many years? 25, okay, good. This is a good crowd. You guys are really smart because there's sometimes some crowds that... They're like, I think it may be a demographic thing. Could be wrong. Anyway, Silver Anniversary. Are we ready?
Okay. I'm ready.
Okay. Yeah, good idea there. Oh, wait. I've got it on the high setting. Nobody wants that. There we go.
Well, it's been quite the morning. I had a flood on the kitchen floor. I found the mirror from my car hanging on the door. But I had to smile when I saw the note of apology. 'Cause on the top it said the date. August 18. 25 years ago today we said I do. 17 years and change since I left you. Maybe you left me instead, I don't remember anymore. This silver begin to be ignored. Pleasure of your company was requested on that day. We stepped into the bright sunshine and then we drove away. It was no mistake to marry you and no mistake to leave. I still wonder what it's like to have anniversary. Our kids might have rented a hall, invited all our friends, raised a glass to wondering where the years went. And would it be a happy time or would we just pretend? Thank you. walked into the bright sunshine and then we drove away. It was no mistake to marry you and no mistake to me. I still wonder what it's like to have a silver anniversary.
Thank you. That's for Colleen. Yeah.
I love that song.
Aw, thanks. What you got, Bob?
I think I'm going to do a song by, I'd like to do a couple, at least one of my own tonight maybe, but there's my new friend, and write this down and Google her, please. I'm Bobby C. Dove from Montreal. is someone I saw her playing in Lethbridge. She, my friend Lance Lurie from the Nanton area, a great guitar player, was playing with her. And so I wandered into this place called the Owl Acoustic Lounge in Lethbridge. And the minute she started singing, my jaw just hit the floor and rolled right out the door. She's really something. She's kind of an alt country. She wants to be Graham Parsons, I think, which is not necessarily the wisest thing to want to be, as I pointed out to her. But and she's just terrific. And you can find some of her music online. You buy her latest record. I listen to it on the road all the time. And I was talking to her the other day, and she wants me possibly to do a show with her this summer, and I couldn't be happier. So. But, you know, she's young and she's caught up in the, you know, the mystique of the road. And this is a song about that that she wrote. I think it's great.
Hey, sorry.
Yeah, in the key of A. And it's
about.
Sorry, we did run through these earlier, but just briefly, we haven't seen one another for a year, and of course I didn't know Bobby C. Dove even existed a year ago. Enough about Bobby. And by the way, Jana in Texas is in fact listening. Hey,
hi,
Jana.
Hi, Janet. Where's Cameron? Hey, Janet. And whoever else is tuning in, I have a friend in Finland who I'm encouraging to tune in because she really can't get here. So, you know.
All right. Hank Williams, are you watching me? Do you walk with me? Do you talk with me? Do you want to? Feedback on the mic line tells me that you do. Let me play another song to please you. I am just a lonely soul, searching for my better half. I found it. Honky tonks, pretty girls, and truck stop dreams. Nothing seems to satisfy me. Heroes often die in the making. They leave their loved ones. Their hearts breaking. They sing their last notes, their voices shaking. They know it's too late to go. Thank you. had a rant with Towns Van Zandt, laying his money down in the roadside boulevard. He liked his women soft and his drinking hard. Bet his bottom dollar on a wild card. Heroes often die in the making. Men leave their loved ones, their hearts breaking. They sing their last note, their voices shaking. They know it's too late to go. Too late to go home. Thank you. And I don't think I did that quite like I said I was going to do it when we rehearsed it. Sorry about that.
Yeah,
rehearse? So what's
the
that?
The moral of the story. That's a beautiful tune. Very beautiful. Yeah. So this song that I'm going to do is one that I wrote when I was down in Texas. And I always say if you can't write a song when you're down in Texas, then you got a problem. Because, I don't know, there's a lot of great songwriters down in Texas. So this is a song that I wrote, it's going on 7 years ago now when I was down in Texas on a little songwriting retreat. This song I actually wrote in the last, day and a half that I was there of the 2 weeks I was there. It's sinking again a little bit, I think. It could just be me that I loosened it and didn't tighten it, and yeah. Okay. Especially with finger picks on. Okay. Okay. Yeah. Thank you. Tim. Yay, Tim. Fantastic, fantastic, fantastic sound. I was kind of dry for songs the whole 2 weeks almost, and the last little bit I managed to pull one out. And this song actually recorded when Bob and I were down in Nashville for a Resophonic Guitar Summit, Reso Summit. And so I recorded it the day before the summit started, and then I got the little, the like rough mix. Bob and I drove down to the venue for that night and popped the CD in the CD player. It was like Bob was the first one to hear.
Well, you got to understand this story because I was, in Nashville, and I love Nashville. And when I'd gotten off the plane and gone to the rental car counter and was having this strange conversation with a clerk there, and I finally realized the upshot of this conversation was. There was a question. The question was, how would you like to drive around Nashville for a few days in a BMW for an extra $5 a day? And I didn't think there were really two answers to that question. And then I wind up riding with Sue in this BMW, listening to the record that she's just recorded. And that was pretty cool. This is the stuff that, dreams are made of, I thought.
All right, so this one's called I'm a Drifter.
I became a drifter by default and by degree. It seemed my path was to be alone. On good days, alone means free. So I took it all. 48, Texas to Carolina, and the songs led the way, 'cause drifter. I never miss the sunset, my shepherd and my guide carries me to the ones I love across some great divide. Whenever clouds come rolling in between me and the light, putting up a fight, 'cause I'm a drifter. Oh, a drifter, and I learned my love when I'm on the road. You love me best when you let me go. I'm a drifter.
Thank you. Thanks, folks.
You know about a song about the snakes?
Song about the snakes. Yeah. Yes. This is from Bob's Greatest Hits album from 1972.
Medley of my hit. I'm actually going to record this thing very soon, I think, because everybody seems to resonate.
Resonate.
Yeah. Oh, ha. Yeah, okay. But, Jana, if you're listening, I don't think you've ever heard this, because it's not a song I sing in Texas, because you just never know who's listening.
You got to watch what you say when you're in Texas.
But, yeah, my friend Bill, who I talked about earlier, did talk about the snake handling creatures, and that seemed like quite a thing to me, and I read a bit about it, and then sure enough, they do it. And I started to write a song about it, and then it just wasn't going anywhere for me, so I put it away and forgot about it until a few years ago. I think it was 2012. I read about a 30-something preacher in one of these snake-handling congregations who died, and of course he died of snake bite, and he's been laid to rest in a little cemetery by the church, right next to his father before him, who died of the same cause, and of course deserving of a Darwin Award, and there's a certain irony to that, I think, given his probable view of Mr. Darwin. But so I thought I'd better try and write that song, and I did, and I hope you like it. Sue came up with this idea today that involves an extra bar. Remember that? It was really
right,
cool.
That was my idea, yeah.
I think it makes the song. But
And what key are we in again?
What?
G?
Oh, it's in C.
Right.
Yeah.
I knew that.
Okay, anyway, it goes like this here. It's a country song. My daddy went to Jesus. He was 33. He didn't leave no insurance for sister, ma, and me. He was just a humble preacher in a church down in the dell, where folks would dance with poison snakes to save their souls from hell. Daddy was a snake handling man in a little backwood church in Alabama. Gunny sack from a room behind the stairs. Diamondbacks and copperheads is what he kept in there. And in our Sunday finest, we'd climb in that old Ford with a bag of buzzing, hissing vipers slithering for the Lord. Daddy was a snake handling man in a little backwood church in Alabama. He'd say a prayer to Jesus, then he'd take one in his hand. Daddy was a snake handling man. I gotta pick one. Shouted as we laid him in the clay. The gate to heaven straight ahead, but narrow is the way. And if you'd stand beside him when the angel trumpets sound, we'll grab you up a rattlesnake to start jumping up and down. Daddy was a snake handling man. Help us out in a little backwood church in Alabama. To do that little. What do you think? I think that improves the song. I think I'm going to keep doing it that way. And they do. You can actually watch them on YouTube, and they hold them and they jump up and down in a very non-sensual kind of dancing. it's really very creepy.
Well, I hope we got some blues fans in the crowd. I know we've got a couple at least. Yeah. Excellent. Woo!
Is this one you want?
Yeah.
To play Weisenborn on? Or no, this one.
Dobro, I think.
Okay.
So this is a song by Big Mama Thornton. Yep. She wrote Hound Dog, if you're not aware. But you guys are so smart, as we've already established. Yeah, I can't, you know, there's nothing I can teach you folks. But anyway, yeah, Big Mama Thornton song. It's called Walkin' Blues. Not to be confused with the Walkin' Blues of Robert Johnson, who was kind of one of the early blues dudes a lot of people know. Yeah, so I don't think we played this one this afternoon, Bob. But you just joined right in, have a good old time.
She was from Texas, wasn't she? Big Mama Thornton.
Big Mama was from Texas. Yeah. There we go. There's a through line here. Lots of Texas going on. Okay, here we go. Well, I guess I'll start walking. I got on my traveling shoes. Make me cry. All our time together, that man lived a love down dirty life. I guess I'll start walking. I'm gonna find better times somewhere. Oh, yes, I will. Well, you know it's hard, hard, hard to love someone who won't. Thank you. Thanks, folks. Big Mama. How's everybody doing? Good. Did y'all get some rain today? Get your daily dose of rain. Yep. It doesn't rain in Victoria, though, right?
No, no.
Come on, you guys. You got to be with me on this.
Stuff in the key of A.
Yeah, ballady stuff in the key of A. That's my middle name.
I had this song I wrote about, you know, an unrequited love affair. If it's unrequited, is it a love affair, really? I mean, we're talking complete unrequition here. Not
like,
you know,
she doesn't know you exist, kind of.
Yeah, it was not sullied by anything like, you know, physical proximity.
That would be called stalking, Bob.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay, here's one about a requited love affair, and I wish I had written it, but I didn't. It's an old cowboy song called Spanish is a Loving Tongue. Eric Bibb says, tuning is always worth it. Spanish is loving tongue, soft as music, light as spray. There was a girl I learned it from, living down Sonoma. Like a lover, but I'd say her love words over. Mostly when I'm all alone, me and more Nicole is home. She would listen for my spurs, throw those big doors open wide, raise those laughing eyes. How those hours get to flying, all too soon I'd hear her sigh. In her little sorry tone, mi amor, mi corazón. Since that night, I can't cross the line, you know. They want me for a gambling fight. Like as not, it's better so. And yet I've always sort of missed her. Since that last sad night, I kissed her. Lost my heart and left to roam. Adios, mi corazón. Lost my heart and left to roam. makes me cold. I played one you hadn't done.
That's beautiful. And whose song is that, Bob?
I can't remember the name of the guy who wrote it. I thought it was a traditional song, but there actually is an old cowboy poet that it's ascribed to. But it's an old song. I learned it from Charlie Ewing, of course, who learned it from an Ian and Sylvia record. There was a pattern. You see, we were roommates at this boarding school that our parents had sent us to, and for reasons that, well, I didn't understand. And he was the cowboy, and I was the hippie, and, you know, he taught, you know, me some of those songs, and I was teaching him Simon and Garfunkel songs, and then we lost track of one another for decades, and now we perform together again. It's pretty cool.
It's very cool. Hanging out with friends around music. So this is a song that I wrote. It's called Love Never Follows the Rules. And there's some, you know, kind of a popular idea that... you know, if you don't love yourself, then you can't love anybody else. And, you know, there's all these sort of ideas out there about love. And many of them I ascribe to off and on. But I've come to understand it really just a mystery. And, you know, I don't know that anybody understands it. We're just all works in progress when it comes to loving each other. And this is a song that I recorded up at Woodshop Recording Studios up north of Duncan. And so Zach Cohen there is possibly, as we speak, is working on the recording of it. So slowly but surely getting some recordings done. So this one is Love Never Follows the Rules.
Someone else. They could have been lying, or
Thank you, folks. Thank you.
Maybe I should play something on the Weisenborn.
Sure, what the heck?
Tune to an open D, and it's almost a shame to the tune, the melodies just fall off this tune here. I love it. And just John, there was this coffee house that we all hung out with, in Lethbridge back in the day, that someone named Marv DiGiorgio had started, and John remembers that. And I was in high school at the time, but I used to go there and pretend to be, try to be a folk singer. It's kind of one of the places where some of us were learning to do that. And there was a lot of new musical things happening, and the Birds had come up with Sweetheart of the Rodeo, and it was just a folk, and folk rock were starting to get infused with country, and a lot of exciting stuff going on. But a guy came to town, and he was from Utah or something, a good singer, and he came visited the coffee house, and he got up and sang this song, which was on a Poco album, but none of us had heard it. Turned out it was an old country song, and nothing was ever the same, before or since. I mean, it was just changed our lives, and everybody started doing this song. And it's called "The Barmaid in the Honky Tonk Downstairs." Well, it won't be long now till that old sun goes down, and darkness helps me hide my shameful tears. She's gone. My wife works all night long for a man who's halfway is gone. She's a barmaid in the honky-tonk downstairs. It's a shame she wears the name of a man that's locked and chained to a bar that's destroyed all hope and care. To the men with hungry eyes, she works and hides her pride. She's a barmaid in a honky tonk downstairs. I gotta do one. Honky tonk downstairs. Decker.
Bob Blair. Gotta love those old hurting songs.
Oh, yeah. And a lot of hurting there.
A lot of hurting.
For sure.
Absolutely. Well, where are we at here? How are y'all doing? Still enjoying, engaged?
Conscious?
Yeah, we'll go with that. That's good. I'm good with that. I'm not happy
doing
with
I was
that.
Playing Weisenborn and you were playing that. What was that?
That was 2 hours ago, Bob. How do you expect me to remember? Well, you did a Willie Nelson tune, but that was on. I know, but that wasn't the one that you were thinking of, the Willie Nelson. Okay.
Anyway, you should have been there. It was really cool.
Yeah, the Falcon Rest. It was the place to be this afternoon.
Yeah. It's the glamour of the road, folks.
Yeah, exactly. And I can't make this tuner work.
Here.
Let's try your other snark.
Snark.
Sorry, I just had to do that. It had to be done. Yes, thank you. Yeah, somebody had to do it. Oh, there we go. Yes.
It's my kind of socialism, a snark on every headstock.
Okay, that's feeling better. Kind of, yep. Thank you. All right, so we're gonna do a tune called "Your Love." This is a song that I played here, maybe even last year. I did some recording. Tim recorded some of my set, and I made a little EP out of it. So I do have some here if anybody's interested. I think it was a full show maybe that I did. Let's say there were four keepers that made the EP. There was another one that I really like the song. It's called Thunder Road, and I forgot the lyrics in the middle of it, and did some cutesy little thing about that in the middle of the song. And it's like, I'm recording. I should have just But through the magic of Woodshop Recording Studios in North Cowichan, we just clipped that out of there. So you don't get my little, my little story in the middle of the song. But anyway, this one's on it as well. It's called Your Love. Gravity. Your love has put a spell on me. Your love has got me spinning round. My heart's in heaven, but my feet are on the ground. I'm dancing and I'm ecstasy bound. Thank you. Thanks, everybody. I think, yeah, maybe one more. And
okay.
Are you going to do Willie?
Which one was that one? Oh, yeah. Oh, great. Yeah.
So I really, really like this song. Also, Bob mentioned that Willie Nelson turned 84, I think, like in the last week or something. Anyways, and has just released a new CD. And I'm just like, okay, that's good. I got a few more years of making music, hopefully. I was listening this morning to one of my favorite radio stations, which is from Alberta, called CKUA. I encourage you to go online and listen. It's a fantastic show. And the Saturday morning show is called Wide Cut Country. Allison Brock, who's the host, played one of the new songs off the Willie Nelson CD, and it's got one of the best lines I've ever heard. Let's see if I need to get it right. I woke up still not dead again today. Well, that's a way to start your day, isn't it? I woke up still not dead again today. So, anyway. Are you doing the Willie Nelson song?
I am.
Okay.
Yeah, I'd forgotten that we tried it this afternoon. We were just throwing some things around, and it was pretty cool. So. And I forgot all about it.
Hmm.
It's called Yesterday's Wine. Miracles appear in the strangest of places. Fancy finding you here. The last time I saw you was just out of Houston. Sit down, let me buy you a beer. Your presence is welcome to me. This is a hangout of mine. I come here quite often to listen to music and partake of yesterday's wine. Yesterday's wine. We're yesterday's wine. Aging with time. Like yesterday's wine. Yesterday's wine. We're yesterday's wine. Aging with time. Like yesterday's. Travel. Well, I bet you've seen things in your time. Come sit down here with us and tell us your stories. If it's true, you're like yesterday's wine. Yesterday's wine.
Well, thank you, everybody.
Thanks for coming.
Thanks to Tim, once again, for fabulous sound, and to Long John for keeping Duncan Showroom open. Please frequent the Duncan Showroom.
Yes, and maybe we'll be back next year.
Maybe we'll be back next year at the end of April.
We're not going to be yesterday's wine for quite a few years yet.
I'm back.